What is on my mind most of the day? What am I most consumed with? Probably most people in this room, it's gonna be school, right? I mean, this is true. And this is the point, is what happens is school, again, legitimate, right? It's a legitimate cause, and inshallah, it can be, a good cause, in fact. But the problem is when we turn the means into the end. The problem is when we turn the means into the end. Let me talk about what, let me explain what I mean by that. So if I'm trying to get back to Orange County, Orange County is my end, it's my goal. And then my means, the way that I'm gonna get there is my car. Okay? So that's means and end, right? Now the problem is I don't get anywhere when I turn my car into my end. Okay, so now I've switched things around and now my car becomes my goal. So now what's gonna happen is I'm gonna get in my car and I'm not gonna go anywhere because I've turned it into the goal itself. If we enter into education, for example, and education is supposed to be a means or an end? A means, right? What's the end? The end is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is our ultimate end in everything that we do? It should be Allah. Our problem begins when we don't realize and we put other things as our end. When we put other things as our goal other than Allah, that's when we suffer. That's when we get into trouble. So in this case, if school is our end, what happens after I graduate? What happens after I graduate? What happens for some people after they graduate is they actually like go into sort of depression or something. And what happens basically is like I lived my whole life for this. It was basically, it consumed my life. It almost became my goal, right? It became my goal. And then now what? And it's this concept of now what? When you make something temporary your goal, and then once you get there, then you fall into sort of this drop, this disillusionment, this now what? Because it was never the goal itself. It should have been the means. It should have been the vehicle, the car in this case. And if you use everything in your life as that means, as that goal, as that car to take you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then everything, assuming it's halal and according to the sunnah, can be blessed. And everything can actually be a worship for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, that I have not created jinn and human beings except for one purpose. We live for a lot of purposes, unfortunately. But Allah is saying that this is our actual purpose, is the reason why He created us, is to worship Him, is to fulfill ubudiyyah to Allah. And so if we're not fulfilling that purpose, we're always gonna suffer. We're never gonna be satisfied, and we're always gonna suffer because we're not actually, it's kind of like you have a certain appliance and you're not using it for what it was intended for. Okay, you can't you mean you can't I mean you can't take a blender and expect to like cook things in it, right? It has a particular purpose. If you don't use that tool the way that it was created to be used, it's going to do a couple things. One, it's going to break, right? And second, it's not going to work properly. The human being, if the human being isn't doing its per if the human being is not living for the purpose for which it was created, it's going to break and it's not going to work properly. And that's why we as human beings, we fall into this where we're not working properly, right? There's something wrong. And the human heart itself was created for only one purpose. It was only created to know and love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was not created for any other purpose.